Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Zin from Commonwealth Investing, and in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you 3 reasons why I love investing and 3 reasons why you should too. Now, before we get any further into the video, let me actually give you a brief background of myself and how I grew to love investing. So for myself, I actually grew up in a family which did not teach me investing nor the importance of investing. Growing up, I knew little to nothing about investing, and actually, if anything, I thought that investing was something that was really risky. You know, how could I actually afford to take such large risks with my money if I was going to have to work so hard for it? And that was the mindset that I actually had back then. But now I've started to learn these various things about investing, and these things actually drew me into investing and actually motivated me to learn so much about investing. These 3 different things about investing are what I'm going to share with you today. So without any further ado, let's bring you through the 3 pointers of the day. Now, the first reason that I love investing and the first reason that you should too is that investing is the single best way to build your wealth. Now, before we even look at that, let's look at what happens to your money when we leave it alone and do absolutely nothing with it. Now, doing absolutely nothing with your money, this thing called inflation is going to come in and erode the value of your money slowly. Now, inflation actually occurs at a rate of around 2 to 2.5% per year, and that actually means that every year your money actually decreases in purchasing power or in value by about 2 to 2.5%, and that's why inflation is called the silent thief. Now, that actually doesn't mean that your money is going to go down in terms of how much you have, but it's just going to go down in terms of how much you can do with it and how much you can purchase with it. And now at a rate of 2% per year, your money is actually going to get eroded over the course of 36 years to about half its original value. And at about 2.5%, you can expect half of your value of your money to be gone within 28 years. Now, 28 years and 36 years doesn't actually sound like it's going to pass very, very quickly. But if you think about it, that's probably just the amount of time you'll actually spend on the workforce. Now, on the other hand, if your money was invested into the stock market, we can take a look at what would happen with it. Now, the US stock market has historically generated up to 10% in the long term. And now 10% actually translates to you doubling your money within a period of roughly 7 years and 4 months. Now, just think about that. In 7 years and 4 months, your investment would have been doubled. In another 7 years, 4 times. In another 7 years, 8 times, and in another 7 years, 16 times your original investment. Now, over the same period of slightly over 28 years, choosing whether to increase the amount of money that you have by 16 times or actually decrease the value of your money by about 50%. Now, to me, that's actually a no-brainer. And that's definitely why I think that investing is one of the crucial ways that you can grow your wealth over the long term and actually not lose your value of your money to inflation. And now the second reason that I love investing is simply that investing builds financial discipline. Now, financial discipline is actually just, you know, not spending too much on my everyday life, not spending too much money on things that I don't need, and even when it comes to things that I do need, being able to save and being able to make good spending decisions. Now let me give you an example of this. When I was first starting out this YouTube journey, I actually thought about getting more expensive equipment. You know, I took a look at some of the cameras online and I saw that, you know, this camera was able to shoot in 4K and this camera was able to shoot in Ultra HD, and I really wanted all of these different things to help my YouTube videos to stand out. But I actually decided, no, you know, I have everything that I need. I have a phone camera, I have a mic hanging around, I have a light stand that, you know, I just bought off Amazon for $20. And I figured all of that was actually more than enough, more than what I needed to start my YouTube journey. And so that being said, I saved a good amount of money there by not spending on a camera, not spending on more expensive light equipment, and all of those actually gets channeled towards eventually my investments. Now there's actually a saying in personal finance circles that goes, tax yourself first. And the idea behind this is that everybody wants a certain cut of your income. You know, the government needs to take taxes off of your income. You have to, you know, give money to your family or to your children if you have children. You have to be able to spend money on certain essential things. But most critically, investing teaches you to tax yourself first. For you to set aside a portion of your money to save and to invest as the very first thing. And that definitely helps to build a lot of financial discipline. Now for myself, I actually have three places where I store my personal money, which is my savings account, my brokerage account, as well as just my wallet. Now my wallet actually holds all of the money that I need for living on a month-to-month basis. But before I actually spend that money, I allocate some of my money towards my savings, towards keeping in cash just for a rainy day, and the rest of it actually goes into my brokerage account where I use it to purchase stocks and shares. Now the idea behind this again is to tax yourself first, to save for your own future first before you even start spending it on things that you might want and things that you need. So that is one thing that investing has taught me, and it actually carries over to so many other areas of my life. You know, in so many things, it's actually so important that we give up some things now in order to enjoy them more in the future. Whether it be things like your diet, where you're giving up, you know, certain sugary foods now to enjoy better health later on, or exercise, whereby you're giving up some of your time right now in order to ensure that you live a long, healthy life. Now, there are so many things that I can learn from investing, and that's absolutely why I've grown to love investing so much. Now, the third and final reason why I love investing, and why you should too, is that investing opens up your eyes to the world around you. Now, let me explain a little bit about what I mean when I say this. Now, when I was investing into some technology stocks, I actually took the time to read up about what different technologies were in the market, what were some of the latest and most promising technologies on the market. I read about different business models, I read about this company and all of its competitors, and I actually learned so much in that process. Now the same actually goes when I was investing into oil stocks. I went ahead to read about what sweet oil was, what light oil was, the geography of oil, how the OPEC works, how different things about the oil industry actually works, and that actually taught me so much as compared to, you know, if I was just trying to read a book about oil for no particular reason. And that's why I love investing. If you want to invest into technology stocks, then you can go ahead to be a little bit of a tech geek and go ahead and read up on all the different technologies. If you want to invest into banks, you can go ahead and read up into what all the different banks are doing. And if you want to read up about oil, you can go ahead and do that as well. So investing really allows you to explore each individual field and in fact train yourself to be at the very least well informed about these different things. And investing truly opens up your eyes to the world around yourself. And just as we were talking about investing actually opening up our eyes to the world around us, one of the things that the stock market has been so concerned about is the coronavirus pandemic, which actually induced a panic-related sell-off as early as 2 months ago last year. Now, the coronavirus pandemic is still something that's raging on throughout the globe, and some of the worst hit people are actually the least fortunate people. And as people who are actually well enough to save and to invest for our own futures, we can consider giving away a small part of it to help some of the people who are suffering right now. And I'm talking about none other than the United Nations Coronavirus Response Fund. Now, the UN COVID-19 Solidarity Response Fund actually seeks to help those in less fortunate circumstances, such as refugees, actually coping with coronavirus, and we can actually consider to give a small amount of our own money to help them. Now, I'll attach a donation link right in the bio so that you can go ahead to learn a bit more about what the United Nations does in combating the coronavirus and whether or not you're able to help out some of these people actually suffering from the coronavirus still. Now that is it for today's video. As always, if you have any questions about today's video or any comments about what you'd like to see us do in the future, please drop a comment in the comment section below. Be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.